My name's Cliff Hodges. Welcome to CrossFit West in Santa Cruz, California. Today we're going to be doing 5 rounds, 7 dumbbell squat clean thrusters at 35 pounds and 10 pull-ups. We're starting with a dynamic but kind of slower warm-up. We're starting with some hip opening exercises to really get those hip flexors open because we've got all those squat clean thrusters coming up in the workout. So I'm going to start with the hips and then we'll also move to the shoulders and get those for going overhead with the dumbbells as well. Okay guys, let's grab some sticks, start opening up the shoulders. We've got the thrusters as well as the pull-ups in this workout, which are going to be pretty shoulder intensive. So we really got to be careful about warming up that shoulder. It's a really unique joint in that it's a ball and socket as well as a slide. If we don't get it properly warmed up and get that connective tissue loosened up, you can get some grinding going on up there. And over time, that really wears on the shoulder joint and produces scar tissue. So here at CrossFit West, we really focus on a lot of shoulder mobility before our workouts.
My name is Eric Barnum, and I am 605 on the workout. And my advice would be not to break up your pull-ups and rest at the bottom of the dumbbells.
Start this workout in 3, 2,
it was a hard one.
1, go!
Good, really use those hips. Use those hips to jump the dumbbells up. Your arms are going to get tired if you're pressing. Let's not make it a press. Really drive out of the hole.
My name is Liz Stewart. I got 509.
What do you think of the workout? What advice would you give?
It's a forearm burner.
Nice, guys. Tune over the bar, arms locked out. Notes on standards. Obviously, we're all pretty familiar with pull-up standards, but on those dumbbell squat clean thrusters, we want to make sure the dumbbells are going all the way back to the ground each time. So it's definitely not from the hang. It's a full clean from the ground. You want to make sure that the entire dumbbell, both sides of it, touch the ground, touch the mats, okay? So make sure you're not banging just one end of the bell. It's the full bell, both ends of it, okay? On the ground after each movement or to start each movement. So starting from the ground, going to clean to the shoulders, ride it into a squat, press out overhead, and then it's gotta come all the way back down to the ground each time. Be real careful of that bounce. As you get tired, you're gonna really have the tendency to bounce off one end of the bell, and that's gonna be a no rep.
My name's Matt. Time, I got 4:38.
What do you think about the workout?
Oh, it was a lot harder than I thought. It was misjudged that you know, you're holding onto the bar the whole time and then the dumbbells the whole time. So, it works a lot of your forearms and tendons, your bicep as well. So, it was hard, but a good, quick workout.
Any tips for people that are gonna do this?
Maybe you start using the hook grip for the dumbbells so it takes a little less pressure off your forearm. But other than that, just go as fast as you can and then just hold on.
6:05.
How do you feel right now?
Shitty.